Hello, hello, and welcome to this episode of the Superwomen Wellness Connection Channel. I'm so excited to be here and having a superwoman who's going to share with you her journey and transitions to self-care and self-love from her experiences in 2020. So for those of you who are just tuning in for the first time, my name is Kim Goldthom. I'm a certified master wellness coach, as well as the founder of the Empowered Living for Superwomen program. And I'm so excited to have with me here today, Renee Champagne Davis. Welcome, Renee.
Hi.
Hi. I'm so excited. I'm so excited to have you here.
And hey, a long time coming.
I know, right? Definitely, definitely. And for those of you who don't know Renee, I'm so excited to be having you have a glimpse into her life and a little bit about what she's done, and she's going to share some wellness tips. She is the founder and owner of Sustaining Youth and Families. She is a certified teacher, yoga therapist. She's got her master's in clinical mental health from College of William & Mary. She's also a veteran. She's working on her clinical hours, and she's also ambassador for Warriors at Ease. She has 1,000 other titles, but we're going to go with those for right now. So welcome, Renee.
Thanks, Kim.
I'm so glad you're here, and I'd love for you to share with everyone a little bit about what prompted you to start Sustaining Youth and Families.
Yeah, so good question. In 2007, basically like the height of the war, I was stationed in Germany and with my husband, and there were no classes for children or moms, and there wasn't really any yoga. So there was no alternative ways to help people cope with the effects of war or transitions. And then there was and mental health issues. And so I started Mommy and Me classes, and then they took off, and then I started teaching yoga, and that took off. And then when I got back to the States, I know in my own recovery and my kids' recoveries from having dual parents and them having to go through a divorce and the traumas that I had experienced, it wasn't only a mental health therapist that would help. It was everything else as well. So I wanted to help people who have mental health issues, or to bridge the gap between mental health and wellness. And so, and just kind of teach the healthy eating and the spiritual piece, just really look at the wellness wheel and see what pieces are missing for the family or the individual, and then build that together. So then when they're working on their mental health issue, then they're able to kind of have this complete picture, and they know what pieces they're missing. And it's a lot easier to kind of to accomplish like total health, total functioning.
Nice. That's really nice. And I loved when we were chatting last week about how, you know, you've had so many epiphanies over the last year and how they've really helped you transition into a place of self-care and self-love. And I would love for you to share that with other superwomen that are watching right now.
Yeah. Those of us that are moms or entrepreneurs or work a lot or serve in the military, I know, at least for me, I was reaching for everything on the outside. So I know, how many marathons could I run? How many 50 milers could I run? You know, what board could I be on? You know, how many friends could I have? And everything was focused on the outside, but I was really like dying on the inside, because I was dealing with severe chronic PTSD, TBI, and also then getting diagnosed with cancer and having to have a mastectomy. And I had to really take a step back and let go of my ego and heal and give myself permission to heal. And that meant giving up a lot. I had to kind of restart. So I stepped back from a lot of positions. I didn't become a hermit, but I really just focused on myself and my family, and looked at, took things smaller. And then I'd always wanted to start a company. So my husband and I did that. And with the help of Kim and Wounded Warrior Project, I was able to accomplish that. But there's no way I would have been present or able to do that without really practicing yoga, not just doing yoga, but practicing yoga, really practicing what I was preaching. And, you know, when I was going to therapy, I was actually present in my therapy sessions and not ashamed of them or embarrassed. And, you know, when I'm with my friends, my phone is not with me, that I'm actually, you know, having lunch or meeting with my friends, that, yeah. So just really coming inward. And I really believe by coming inward that I've been able to heal a lot quicker and be able to love a lot more and also be there and be present for my friends, because oftentimes I wasn't, because I was so self-absorbed and so busy.
Wow. That's amazing. That's such a huge aha moment that you've had, and just the way you've been able to incorporate that and the differences it's made. That's really powerful. Thank you so much for sharing that. That's exciting.
Yeah. And I want to say, you know, with our kids too, I was always rushing with my kids and, you know, they're like, you're not listening. And I'm like, yes, I am. But I really wasn't listening. And now, like, when they talk to me, I put it down, you know, and I'm actually present. So I just think that we, especially during this pandemic, is really being present with ourselves, so we're able to be present with others.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And in all that stuff on the outside does not matter. It doesn't matter. All that stuff is just stuff. That's going to come and go. But this, when you look at yourself in the mirror, that's who you see every day. That is with you every day. You are with yourself every day. You can't run away from yourself.
Whether you like it or not, definitely. Yes. So embrace it.
I used to think wine was going to help. I used to think all kinds of running. I used to think all kinds of things were going to help. And I was like, it's not helping. I was still there.
Yeah. You know? Oh my gosh. So if there's somebody out there who's like, oh my gosh, Renee, that's me. That's exactly what I'm doing. What would be that first step that you would recommend for them to take to start this, you know, creating this presence of being present?
Yeah, that's a good question too. So, you know, having that journal is really important. And if you don't have one, just going and purchasing one. That's like the first step. And then in that journal, write down everything you do. So you see it in front of you. So you're seeing everything you do, whether you're on a board, whether this, your kid goes this activity, whether you're selling this, you know, whatever you're doing, write it all down. And if it's like more than, you know, if you kind of have, you're like, wow, I do a lot. Sometimes that's good and sometimes that's not. So that's a decision that has to come from within, you know, what can go and what can't. What's going to help you become more present, find stillness, and find that self-love, and what's not, you know, and being humble, you know, letting go of your ego. Because, you know, when you're tired or cranky or not nice to people, or, you know, or you're not present, people notice that. They notice that outside. I know a lot of people, a lot of my friends that I've known for a long time, they're like, Renee, oh my God, you've changed so much. And I'm like, what? I have? Because I didn't think I changed. But to them, when I began to find happiness, they wanted to be around me more. Nice. You see, so people are going to want to surround you more when you come from that place of, you know, genuine self-love.
Wow. And so how long do you think it took for you to really get into that place of creating that mindful awareness to be present? So if somebody's, you know, trying this and they're taking your tips with the journal, you know, at what point can you let them know it's okay if you make a mistake, or how long is it going to take? What should they be expecting?
So, you know, that's a really good question too. Kim, you've got great questions.
Thank you.
It's probably part of your job anyway, but it took years. You know, I thought when I was in Germany, I was like, oh, I'm going to go become a yoga instructor, and that is going to make me more present, and that's going to make me a better person and make me feel better. Well, yeah, I got trained as yoga, and I was doing yoga and I was teaching yoga, but I wasn't practicing yoga. You know what I mean? I wasn't practicing it in my own life. You know, I thought I was because I was meditating or anything like that, but I wasn't, I just wasn't present with myself, you know? And then, so it took years of eye rest and yoga and going up and down, you know, and just kind of figuring out things, years of therapy. You know, the things that I had to, you know, friendships that I had to let go of. And, you know, I went through a divorce and, which was really hard after many, many years, which I never thought I would go through, but I had to let go of a lot of things that, that were not doing me any service. And that's what I say about like being humble and letting go. I'm not saying like everybody get rid of your husband or get rid of like, you know what I mean? Like, right. You know, everybody go get certified in yoga, but I think that when I went through the mastectomy and I couldn't move and after going through a rape and a divorce and having another piece of me, another loss, I really had to sit down and be like, wow, like, what do I want out of my life? And, you know, with PTSD, with divorce, with rapes, with cancer, it is different for everyone. You cannot compare. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like my mastectomy is different. My cancer is different. You know, there's no comparing of who's worse and mine's worse. You know, rape is rape. Divorce is divorce. Grief is grief. And mastectomy, that's a mastectomy, you know, whether it's one, whether it's two, like, and so, and I had to stop comparing myself and just, this is me, how I deal with it. And I had to, it took me years, like almost 20 years, to be honest with you.
Yeah. And I think that's such a great point. You know, wellness is it's a journey. It's a lifestyle. It's not a quick fix, but we can start one journal entry at a time. And if we have a day where we miss, it happens, we're human, keep moving forward on that wellness journey. So I love that you, shared, you know, so many different layers there to help a person understand it takes time, right?
Mm-hmm. We have to give ourselves a break because everyone's like, oh, give yourself a break, give yourself a break. I mean, yeah, okay, I went to William & Mary. Great. Do you know I had to work my ass off there? Like I had to retake a class, which was really humbling. And my advisor, he was a prior Navy SEAL. He was like, like you are going to earn this. Just because you have a disability, you're not going to use that. And he made me like, I had to redo my internship. It wasn't because I was dumb. I just wasn't ready, you know? And I want to be a really good therapist. I don't want to be a therapist where I'm healing through you. You know what I mean? And so, you know, like what I just said, you know, oh, I'm going to become a yoga instructor and that's going to heal me. Oh, I'm going to become a therapist and that's going to heal me. These outside things do not heal us, people. It's true. Coming within, you know, slowing down, and less is more. Less is more.
I love it. I love it. No, it's fantastic. Thank you. And so if there's anyone out there who's resonating and would like to connect with you, because you have a variety of services that you offer, what's the best way for them to connect?
The best way to connect is to go on sustainingyouthandfamilies.com and send me an email and all the information's right there.
Perfect. Perfect. And I will post that in the description below, but I just wanted to make sure everybody, in case you were listening to this, you may not notice to check out the description below, but there you've got her website so you can go in and connect. Anything else you would like to share with the other superwomen who are watching before I let you get back to doing all the amazing things you do?
No. I think I said a lot, you know?
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Well, I want to thank you so much for your time today and for sharing your wisdom and being so vulnerable so that others can hear that, be inspired by it, resonate, and, you know, take that one step forward and utilize those tips in their own life. So thank you so much.
Thanks, Kim, for being such a support. You're amazing.
Thank you. And you're so very welcome. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye.